Hi folks, I decided to try an experiment, and this might be a complete fail, but I'm outside, and I'm just recording on a headset, and there's going to be a lot of street noise, but there's also beautiful bird sounds. It's spring, and yeah, we'll give it a go, see if it's tolerable. So I have this lovely planter. I want to consolidate all my succulents into one planter. Okay, we've already had to stop once because of a delivery person, so yeah. Anyway, so I have some succulent planting mix. I have my little tool here, which I got from Buy Nothing in my community. I love Buy Nothing. And I have my little succulents here. So, I think I want this one over here. Oh yeah, there's a giant rock or something in here. I don't know that I'm going to put them all in here. Let's see, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I think I'm going to do 5. Over there. Let's see if I can get you a better view. Sure if this is two plants or one plant. If it's two, I'm going to divide it. Yeah, it looks like it might be. Oh, I'm breaking it. Okay, I'm just going to go ahead and put it in the way it is. There we go. And a If any of you are gardeners, you're probably looking on in horror as I do this, because I don't really know what I'm doing, but put any tips you have for me in the comment section. Oh, come on. I just feel so sorry for these little plants going through this uprooting trauma. So the plants, except for one of them, were also gifts from the non-commercial economy. Like the tool was from a group called Buy Nothing, where we give things to each other for free in the community. We organize on Facebook, and I just posted that I was looking for gardening tools, and somebody said, I got some. And this root is so long. Oh, poor baby. And the plants came from a plant swap at a community garden, where you bring any little cuttings you have and you take things back. And I brought some aloe. And I got all these lovely little succulents. Look at the length of the root on this, jeez. I'm sorry, sweetie. I hope you survive this. Okay, that's gonna grow. This only grows in one direction, so I guess I should put it on a diagonal. Okay. Oh, I don't know. Trying to get the root down in the dirt, but not the plant. It's just not going particularly well. Okay, there we go. There we go. All right. Well, that wasn't particularly graceful, but I got it in there. Okay. Succulents are generally safe for cats, so they're pretty much the only plants I have. I also don't have a lot of space, so I don't want things that grow big. Obviously, very root systems are so extensive. I should have done this a while ago.
The cat lady. Good afternoon.
That's my neighbor. He wanted to engage in conversation, but I was not in the mood. He has some mental health issues, and conversations can go on for a long time. So this one that I've just buried in dirt is called Cat's Tongue. I only know the like colloquial names for these plants. I don't know the proper names. And I think the one that I'm planting now is called something like Hobbit's Fingers. Really cool looking. And they have a little touch of color on them. The red in addition to the green. Okay. That's sort of done. All right, we're getting there. Not bad. This little guy fell over already. I did wave at my neighbor. You might not have seen that. I didn't totally blow him off. I just didn't want to call him by his name or talk really loudly in response. Okay, there we go. Getting there. Now I just have... and this one that my cat kind of chewed on. I don't know if you can see that. I've got this bigger one. I don't like the asymmetry of the larger one here. But I don't really love the one that my cat chewed on, the way it looks. So, I think I'll go with the big one. Okay. Oh, unless I can divide these up, let me see. I think these did start out as two plants. They might all be connected now. And I want to learn to, make cuttings of these so that I can give them to other people. Really easy to take care of. Can I divide these up without killing them? I don't know. No, I don't think so. Okay. All right, so you're going back in the dirt. And this little guy is coming out. And this is the only one that I purchased. I got it from a local vendor. It's called a zebra plant, I think. There's several plants that all look very much alike. Oh, this poor little thing. Look at all the roots. Look at the root system. It's so bunched up. Oh, anyway, I hope this thing grows, like, can survive this terrible root problem here. So, yeah, I looked it up on a plant identification application, and there were just a lot that looked very similar to this, but the app seemed to think that it was a zebra plant. I'm not going to mess with this. I'm going to trust that the plant can figure it out, I hope. Try to loosen it up a little bit. Oh, some of these are just dead. Alright, well, here you go, little plant, fresh start. To my world. And this is a really quiet day. It's a Saturday, so it's not the usual work and school traffic. I don't love the way that looks. Okay. And that's okay. Okay, we're getting there. It's starting to look like a little, like I had envisioned it. This video doesn't get flagged for copyright infringement because of that music that's playing. Actually, I'm going to turn it off just in case. Okay, so the music stopped, and unfortunately I hit stop rather than pause. Hopefully I can weave these two things together later. Alright, we're just about done here. Just filling in dirt. I'm gonna give it a good soak. Oh, music again. Okay, we're back. All right. So I'm never sure how you're supposed to like pack down the dirt around the plants. I think the dirt settles later and gets lower. Stand up and see how it looks. Oh, it looks pretty good. It's pretty even. I like it. So, okay, now I just have to replant the little one that I disrupted here. And my watering can is not within reach, so I will do that off camera, but this is this is the front of my house. Beautiful afternoon in the spring. I always think it's amazing that animals manage to exist in this environment. Birds, squirrels, cats, insects. We even have some raccoons and possums and stuff in a very urban environment. And in the larger parks in the city, there are, I think foxes have crossed over in the north, in the Bronx. What's the other thing that was surprising that was living in the parks? I can't remember, but it's pretty wild, even in the midst of all this concrete. So thanks for hanging out with me and doing some planting. I hope you're able to grow some things this spring as well. Bye-bye.